Hello students, welcome back to your history class. So last week you all gave assignment. This week now you're going to be working on your subject enrichment, basically your project, one part of your project. And next week is your multiple choice question exam. This exam is based on the chapter Writing and City Life, that is chapter 2, theme. So what I want to do this week with you all is a revision of the chapter, okay? And we are going to discuss not multiple choice questions, but we are going to discuss short answers, very short answers, value-based questions, the kind of questions that can come in your examination. So for this, you will need your notebooks, you will need your pen, pencils, your writing materials, and you will need your textbook. You will need these three things. So in case you're using an e-textbook, I suggest you sit with two devices. One where you will see the presentation where you're learning the lesson from, and another one where you can use it as a textbook. So whether you sit with an iPad or you sit with another mobile or you sit on the laptop with a mobile, whatever you do, if you're using an e-textbook, you will require two devices. Else you can just use a textbook and the device itself. Okay, so I'm gonna, I want you all to pause the video till you go grab your things. Okay, because I will continue. Okay, so right now I'm gonna start with a quick introduction, a quick revision to the chapter. Okay, it's all in the point form, so you will have to understand the rest. All right. Now, Mesopotamia is derived from two Greek words. Meso means middle and potamus means river. Today, Mesopotamia is a part of Iraq. Okay? This is the map of Iraq. You can see there is river Euphrates and there is river Tigris, and right in the middle of these two words, Mesopotamia. The Tigris River flows through the country of Iraq in the Middle East. The ancient civilization of Mesopotamia grew up on the plain between the Tigris and the Euphrates rivers. Mesopotamia was basically known for its writing, its city life, its trade, its rich literature, mathematics and astronomy, which has spread to Mediterranean, Turkey and Syria, and many of these we are still using. In the beginning, Mesopotamia, the land was called Sumer or Akkad, and the language that they spoke that time was Sumerian. Later on it became Babylonian, and finally Assyrian Empire took over, and that time the language changed to Akkadian. Later the language became Aramaic, and today also it is spoken. Aramaic is spoken today also, and another version of it is Hebrew. These are the Hanging Garden of Babylon. The Mesopotamian city of Babylon was one of the most important cities in the ancient world. This picture shows the Hanging Garden of Babylon, one of the seven wonders of the world. The gardens grew on the roofs and terraces of the royal palace in Babylon. Apparently, 2,500 years ago, King Nebuchadnezzar, he ruled the land called Babylonia. He married a beautiful princess from another country, and he brought her to Babylon, which is the capital of Babylonia. But the new queen, she started to grow homesick, and she wanted to live amongst the mountains and gardens of her homeland. So the king called together all the architects and craftsmen because he had a plan. He told them, build me the most wonderful gardens in the world. So the Mesopotamian city of Babylon was one of the most important cities in the ancient world. This picture shows that Hanging Garden of Babylon is one of the seven wonders of the world. The garden grew on the roofs and terraces of the royal palace in Babylon. Along with six other man-made marvels, Hanging Garden of Babylon are remembered as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. So, like we have Taj Mahal, like that they have Babylon Garden. So we saw this already in the beginning. The land was called Sumerian Akkad, and then the language they spoke was Sumerian. Later it became Babylonian, and then further on we had the Akkadian language takeover. This is the Assyrian attack. The Assyrians came down like the wolf on the fold, and his cohorts were gleaming in purple and gold. This is how a poet imagined the cohorts or the armies of Assyrian soldiers as they were attacking the city of Babylon in 689 BC. They were a terrifying sight. First came the chariots and their drivers, led by the king himself. The king was Sennacherib. Then came the cavalry, which was armed with bows and arrows. And at the back, behind all of them, marched the foot soldiers who were carrying long spears and huge shields. Okay? So after Babylon, there was an attack and Assyrians took over. Mesopotamia is important for Europeans because it is mentioned in Bible's first part. Shimmer means Sumer. According to the Bible, Noah built a huge boat and took a pair of each of all the species of animals and birds which survived the flood. The same story is in Mesopotamian tradition, where the principal character was called Zeusudra or Utnapishtim. So according to the Bible, Noah had built a huge boat and survived the flood. And on the boat, he took a pair of each of the species of animals and birds. That's Noah's Ark. Okay. So with this, I end the revision. Now we are moving further. These are the questions. What you all have to do is these are very short answer questions which come for around 2 marks in your exam, and you have to answer in about 30 to 50 words each. What you have to do is I will read out the question and you will find the answer in your textbook and write them down or mark them. You can select any one. Okay, we will discuss the answer after a little while. Now only. So right now you are going to write these answers down in your notebook. Actually, don't mark them, write them down, because some of these you may not find in your notebooks, or you may find extra points. So you can write in the point form, but write down the question and the answers in your notebook. What do you understand by the word Mesopotamia? What are the important centers of this civilization? What do you understand by the word Mesopotamia? It's okay, you can just mark this. I don't mind if you mark it. But there will be a certain questions which you will not find in the textbook. You will have to write them down. So write down the question in your textbook if you're marking in the textbook. What do you understand by the word Mesopotamia? And what are the important centers of this civilization? I'm going to wait for about 1 minute and then I'm going to give you the answer. Okay. If you find the time less, you can always pause the video. The answer to this question will be that Mesopotamia is a Greek word, which literally means the land between two rivers. You can also split it and say the word meso means river, and meso means middle, and potamia means river, and hence the word Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. What are the important centers of this civilization? You can also write that Mesopotamia in Greek means land between two rivers, and it was so called because the whole area was flanked by two rivers, Tigris and Euphrates. And the four important centers of this civilization were Sumer, Babylonia, Akkad, and Assyria. I repeat, Sumer, Babylonia, Akkad, and Assyria. Okay, now we go to the next question. Name the four cities associated with the ancient civilization of Mesopotamia and describe any one of them. I repeat, name four cities associated with the ancient civilization of Mesopotamia and describe any one of them. Mark them, mark this answer or write this answer down. I'm going to wait for a minute. Whenever you find the time less, pause. Okay. So the four cities associated with the ancient civilization of Mesopotamia. So there were many towns and cities that rose in Mesopotamia, but the most famous of them were Ur, Lagash, Babylon, and Nineveh. Ur, that is UR, then it's Lagash, L-A-G-A-S-H, Lagash, Babylon, and Nineveh, N-I-N-V-E-H. Now, Ur, I'm over here, I am going to describe Ur, but if you want, you can describe any. Ur was one of the biggest cities in Mesopotamia, and it was divided into three main divisions: the sacred area, the walled city on the mound, and the outer town. Sacred area was the most important part of the city, and it was built on the highest top in the middle of the mound. The sacred temple of moon god, who was known as Nannar, was also in this area. The sacred temples were called ziggurat, meaning the hill of heaven. The administrative center was also situated in the sacred area, where there were several offices and storehouses as well. The walled city and the outer town were the residential areas where common people lived in houses built in different sizes. Each house had a central courtyard with rooms around. So this is a description of the city of Ur. I think it would be best if you describe the city because we have the most information on it. Okay, so the four cities are Ur, Lagash, Babylon, and Nineveh. And I have described Ur over here. Next question. Describe in about 30 words the sacred temples of Mesopotamia, which were also called ziggurats. I will again wait for 1 minute and then explain the answer. Okay, I'm going to say the answer now. So if you have not finished, you can always pause. The sacred temples in Mesopotamia were called the ziggurats. Generally, they were built upon an artificial mound and raised in the middle of the town. Out of these ziggurats, the most famous were the temple of moon god Nannar at Ur. Then there was the temple of Enlil at Nippur, and the temples of God Sham, that is sun, at Lagash. These were multi-storied buildings where the upper floor was successively smaller than the lower floor. These temples used to be so high that one could see them from quite a long distance. Okay, so this is description of the sacred temples, also called ziggurats. Next, what were the chief social classes into which the Mesopotamia society has been decided? Or, on the basis of your study, describe the social structure of Mesopotamia. Both of these have the same answer. What were the chief social classes into which Mesopotamia society has been decided? And on the basis of your study, describe the social structure of Mesopotamia. Both of it have the same answer. I'll wait for 30 seconds. All right, I'm giving out the answer, so you can pause if you have not been able to find one. The Mesopotamian society was chiefly divided into three classes. The highest class represented the king, the priest, and the government officials. The king held the highest position in the society, followed by the priest and the government officials. The middle class consisted of the landowners, the merchants, the craftsmen, and the shopkeepers. The slaves, most of whom were prisoners of war, formed the lowest class. The king and the priest lived in luxury, while the middle class people had all the comforts, but the slaves had just a wretched existence. So it was divided into three parts, that is the highest class, that is the kings and the priests. Then there was a middle class, that is the landowners, merchants, craftsmen, shopkeepers who used to live in comfort. And then finally we had the slaves who lived in a very wretched existence. Okay, so with this I'm going to close today's class. For next class, you all can do the question 5 and question 6 and keep it ready with you all. Question 5 is, what were the main arts and crafts that Mesopotamian invented first of all? And question 6 is, what are the important factors responsible for urbanization? I repeat, what were the main arts and crafts that Mesopotamian invented first of all? And what are the important factors responsible for urbanization? We will discuss these answers tomorrow. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take care. Don't stress. Do your SEA work first. Do this later. Okay. Thank you.